Wanna go outdoors? Come on, come on.
There we go. 1, 2, 3. Everybody outside. Yes, I know. Too early, but needed extra rugs. Don't know why this one got layered on top of the other one. Tucker's been slipping a bunch. That's Toby. We're Tucker.
Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party. How's everybody doing?
I hope you're good. I'm great.
Tuck, where are you going? Get out of there. Don't drink out of the bucket. You got a bowl full of water. Why would you do that?
Lots of fun shadows. The sun's at a nice angle for filming videos.
Not really. So I'm getting ready to do some work on some planters. Planters that I have on my front porch with some windmill palms in them. The frost came in, took out the annuals. There was just impatience in them. And I'm going to go ahead and swap those impatiens out with some ornamental cabbage and kale.
They're all very, very full of pine needles because the wind was just blowing the needles right out of the trees this time of year. As you can see, I have an awful lot to choose from. Went a little bit crazy this year with the kales and the cabbages. These have all been waiting to be planted for a pretty long time, so they have some crispy foliage on them. Hey buddy, where are you going? All right, nice to see you. A little bit of cleaning up to do on some of them. Some of them have some brown and dried up leaves. That's okay. The weather here over the last few weeks has been all over the place. It's one of the reasons that there haven't really been vlogs going on. So I thought I'd pick up the camera and we could go ahead and just have like a little bit of plant time together. It just rained and rained and rained the last few weeks of October. There were a few nice days, but they weren't days when I was able to film, so just that didn't matter. And it's nice and warm today too. The last few weeks have been very, very cool. Cool, I mean like practically frigid. It wasn't great for the tropical plants, but the kales and the cabbages, it really helped bring out their colors. They don't tend to take on much color until the nighttime temps start to dip and get cooler, usually like into the 50s Fahrenheit, somewhere in there. Because a few weeks ago when I brought all these home, they pretty much just looked green. So I don't mind having... Hello? Yes, hello.
So it definitely makes it easier to get them planted. Excuse me, Toby, you're taking all the light.
Definitely easier to go ahead and plant these up and establish a pattern if I'm going to have a pattern when laying these out around something else when they have all their colors on them, because then I can more accurately see what they're going to look like. Hard to decide how you're going to lay things out if you want to go like white, purple, or purples and pinks and things like that when they're, if they're all green. It's more difficult to make those decisions. Since I'm doing this on two planters, each one has a palm tree coming right up out the middle. I'm thinking I'm probably going to want to do a full circle around each palm tree and not just the front of the planters. This will all make more sense when I actually get to the front porch, but I wanted to pick out and establish my kale and cabbage pattern before I get there. The dogs are very happy and excited today. Hi, buddy. Hello, buddy. No, I didn't get a new dog. That's my sister's dog. I have family in town visiting, helping me with the fall and winter things. That's why sometimes there's a third dog here. Some of these things do not look like the others. This is a Kamome pink, and then I bet these are Kamome red over here. Yep, Kamome red. Well, that was an accident. These were all supposed to be the pinks. That's okay. And these over here are pigeon white cabbages. You can usually tell the difference between kale and cabbages because the cabbages tend to have much larger, more flat leaves. They're very leathery. Then the kales tend to have more of a frilly texture to the outsides of their leaves.
And so I've gone ahead and divided these into two separate flats because I have two separate planters to plant up. And I picked out 5 of the reds and then 2 of these white cabbages for each planter. I wish that I had one more of these white cabbages so I'd have 3 and 5. That would make a lot more sense. Might look a little bit wonky with just 2, but the problem is these other ones that I have are too big, and you can see they've started to bolt. So when they start to bolt like this, you need to get them planted all the way to there. So that means I have to be able to dig a hole from here all the way down to the bottom of this pot when I would have this planted to help combat that bolting that it's had. And I don't think I can dig holes quite that big or deep in the planters these are going in, unfortunately, because these are absolutely beautiful and I would love to use these, but I just don't think that's going to work. And really, these planters on my front porch, I never even see them, but they will be in my house part of the winter when it's really cold outside and I have to move those windmill palms in, like when it drops below 15 degrees Fahrenheit. Then those will have to come in. So I like the idea of them being kind of nice to look at. The kale and cabbages don't do very well indoors. They tend to appreciate a shift in temperatures between the day and the nighttime. So it's not like I'm planting these up in hopes of having them underplanted as like houseplants. Definitely not the case. They wouldn't do well with that. But if I have to move the windmill palms in for like a week at a time, then these, I think they should be okay. I can't imagine there would be any problems with just a week here and there inside the house. I don't know, only one way to figure it out. Let's go to the front porch and have a look at those windmill palms.
Oh, what a mess. These poor things, they look terrible. So does just the porch in general. I need to give this a good scrub. I haven't noticed the foliage on these fan palms is just dirty. It's dusty. I guess, you know, this is under an overhang, so it's not getting washed off by the rain. So them needing to be cleaned up does make some sense, I suppose. That's not a big deal. Nothing a little soap and water won't fix. That's something I can worry about after I get in here and get all these annuals pulled out. Always sad to have to take the summer stuff out, but hey. It's November. Having the winter plants to put in here, like the kale and the cabbage, that makes it a little bit nicer. Eases the transition a little bit. These planters were really pretty this year. I really enjoyed the combination of the pink and orange that were on the sun and patience. There's nothing to see there. Maybe I'd be able to show you a little bit of something, but they're pretty much all toast at this point. There we go. That's better. A nice blank canvas. And did that on both sides. There's a windmill palm on each side of the door here. I have my scrub brush. Need to get down and do some scrub, and you can see that's pretty gross. I've never had this problem before. I think it's just because the soil I used when I potted up these windmill palms just drained better than what I had in them before, so there's more water coming out the butt. I don't know. It's not a big deal. I just need to scrub it up. And over here on this windmill palm, I had noticed what looked like mealybugs down in here. I'm pretty sure I got them all. But I went ahead and soaped both of these down. Just use a spray bottle with some dish soap and did the tops, the bottoms, the trunk. Did it on each one of them, which I was going to do anyways because I pointed out they were dusty. But this way that soap can sit on there for a while. Same thing with the ground that can sit while I plant these up and then I'll be able to rinse them off. It should look a lot better once I can get those rinsed up. They got really dirty, really nasty. And come down here and start loosening all this up too. I'm going to give this a light scrub right now, since there's a little bit of soap on there, so that hopefully it will rinse up a little bit more easily. It's going to take more than some light scrubbing to get all that up, but it's at least going to be better. Usually with algae, some vinegar does a pretty good job, but I just didn't want to use that on this pavement because it's like kind of dry. I think it needs to be resealed. This will be better than nothing. Gone from a video that was supposed to just be about kale and cabbage to me scrubbing algae off my front porch. It's fine. It's a vlog. It doesn't matter. As far as the way these are laid out in relation to that pot and then the two different colors, I don't know. I'm just going to kind of wing it. This is when I wish I had a tripod, but if you watched my last video, you knew my tripod's broken. I did order a new one, but it's not here yet. By the time this video comes out, it should be here, hopefully. I think what would make the most sense is to go ahead and get the red ones in here and then see if I can tuck the white ones in. See if I can just like put one on each side. Maybe that might be the way to do it. I don't know. And one problem that I had anticipated, and I kind of talked about this when I was out in the backyard picking up the kales and the cabbages, is that there's not a ton of space to plant in these pots. These windmill palms, they did a great job rooting out, which is fantastic. Not complaining about that at all, but it doesn't leave a ton of room to plant deep. I can't quite get that stem buried on most of these. I really don't want to disturb the root mass of the windmill palms. They grow so slowly. It's not something I want to mess with. Whatever, a little bit of stem will stick up. That's okay. It's not the end of the world. Yep, that'll do. I'm okay with it. Looks better than nothing and way better than a bunch of dead impatience. For the time being, I went ahead and just did two reds, two whites, and then two reds behind them. So I cut out one from each planter. I figure if I happen to be at a nursery and find a couple more of those white cabbages, then I can put one in the front and in the back and that'll even things out. And if not, then that's okay. It's fine. This'll do. I don't spend a lot of time on my front porch looking at these things anyways. Main thing was just have a little bit of color out here, have them looking better than they did with just nothing in there. Just a little pop of color, and this will be fine throughout the majority of the winter. The kales and cabbages, they tend to be extremely cold hardy. I'm in zone 6B. They are in a pot, which does take down some of their hardiness. It makes them a little bit less hardy because their roots and everything are more exposed. However, I have these potted up here with these windmill palms. Those have to go inside when temperatures drop below about 15 degrees Fahrenheit, so they'll spend some time inside. So they'll never really be exposed to the extreme colds that they would be if they were in the ground. The ground's a little bit warmer. You get what I'm saying. They won't be out here when it's dreadfully cold. Not that 15 degrees Fahrenheit isn't cold, but at least they won't be out here when it's like negative 10. Things are bright out here. It's nice to have that pop of color. During the holidays, I might put some picks and sticks and pine cones, something like that in there. I don't know. I'll figure that out when it's time to do that. This planter over here, that's going to the backyard here in a few days. That's why I only gave things a light scrub, because when I move this, the alyssum is going to just, it's going to be a disaster. It's going to be a beautiful disaster, just white and purple flowers everywhere. Having the impatience out of this should also be very beneficial to this creeping Jenny. I say that because it was getting extremely crowded in there. You can see where it was starting to have some some die back and some die off. So that things are opened up a little bit more, that'll allow it to go ahead and put out new growth. Won't be smothered quite as much. So that's good too. This is starting to look kind of ratty and raggedy. And typically it's best to get the kales and cabbages planted and into the ground roughly, I mean, if possible, 4 to 6 weeks before the first frost. Even though the frost really isn't going to affect them at all, that just gives them enough time to put down their roots and establish themselves. I'm pretty late in the season to be planting these, but it's looking like the first few weeks of November are going to be unseasonably warm here. Like, it's like 76 right now. 3 days ago it was 28 degrees, but today it's very toasty. And it still looks like we're going to have plenty of days where temperatures are going to be above 60, which is kind of a good spot for these for getting them planted. So they should have at least a few weeks to establish themselves. Still not quite enough. So what happens if they don't establish themselves, they just kind of stay the same. They get frozen in place. This is pretty much what these are going to look like all winter. Not expecting to see any growth out of them. So I didn't add any fertilizers. There's a little bit of compost amended into the soil, but I didn't want to put any, especially any synthetic fertilizers into these mixes because I don't want to trigger the windmill palms to grow. They need to, it's going to get cold. That would be very bad for them. And sometimes those synthetic fertilizers can really affect the coloration on the kales and cabbages, and I want these to be nice and bright and pretty and have that pop of color. That's why I just stuck with compost. That's really more than enough for these. They've been planted up earlier in the season, then it'd be a different story, but nope, late to the game. And that's okay. Better late than never, right? I still have some fall planters left to do, or really winter planters, that is, and if I have any leftover pansies when I'm done with those, then I might tuck those into these just for a little bit more color, but I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Everything that goes in these needs to be totally non-toxic and safe to take in the house because of my pets. Kale and cabbage is debatably safe for the pets. There's a high amount of oxalates in there, but it's up high, so I don't really have to worry about that falling down. Like, they have big leaves, so it's not like I won't notice those dropping to the ground where the animals can get to them. And the creeping Jenny in the wintertime, I'll just pick it up and do that with it. I let it hang out up there. Because even if it's safe for the cat to eat it, I don't really want them to. And if it's dangling, it just has cat toy, cat treat written all over it. You know that any cat's gonna be all over any dangly stringy thing like that. Anyways, that's gonna do it. Feels good to be outside, to be doing some planting. It was so rainy and so cold. It's nice to be able to get out and enjoy the nice weather. What are some things y'all been doing in your garden? Staying busy or just clean up? I'm kind of like at an in-between place with all that right now. Comment down below. Love talking to everybody. Say hi. Tips, tricks, suggestions, always appreciated. That looks fantastic. And I hope y'all are doing well, having a great day, a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.